Now, as I mentioned in another video, Des Moines was incorporated in, well, Iowa was established as a state in 1851. And Des Moines itself went on a tear, and an economic tear, because they were, first of all, they were digging coal everywhere. I mean, they had 15, 20, 30, 40, 50 coal mines in the city limits. You could use coal as money. Coal was so popular. In fact, they had almost as many miners as bigger, much bigger cities in the United Mining Union, right? They had almost as many miners in Des Moines, coal miners, as much bigger cities. There was so much coal in the area. Now they eventually exhausted it because capitalism, but at the time it was a big thing. Coal was number one. Now oil was number two. You had oil derricks throughout the city. And in fact, sometimes they built a building and put an oil derrick on top. So, in other words, the pipe and the drill went up the side of the building. And the reason for that is they got much better leverage by having the derrick on top of the building. So, when I say building, you're thinking building, like 50 stories. No, in those days, a four-story building was a building. Well, that was a skyscraper. So then they put the derrick on top, and so they got much better leverage on the aim. If you've ever tried to aim the drill bit, it's not very easy. So if you can get that leverage from the top of a 40, so you're talking about what, 10 feet per story, so 40 feet above, you're gonna have a much better shot at getting that drill bit into the hole and drilling for oil. And of course, that was the second most popular resource in the area. So you had coal and you had oil. Now, sometimes they were digging for coal, digging a mine shaft, and they hit oil. And in other cases, they were drilling for oil and they hit coal. And so they called it coal oil. Or in the case of the original one, it might be oil lol. So it's coal and oil together, oil lol or coalac, however you want to say it. So because of that, the city grew. And by the 1880, you had more than 20,000 people. 20,000 people, most of which were miners. So that means they all had mining hats with the light on. So that meant they could party all night. We don't care if the sun goes down, they said. We're gonna keep drinking whiskey until we're gonna fall down. So sometimes they would party and then they'd put the mining hats on and go from bar to bar in downtown Des Moines. Now remember, downtown was where all the mine shafts were and the oil rigs. But a mine shaft, you got to be careful. And it wasn't unusual for a miner to go tumbling down a mine shaft after he had too many bourbons, okay, on Friday night, Saturday night. So what they would do is they'd go from bar to bar with their lights on their helmet. And singing. They're like, oh, ee-oh. So you'd see these lights going through the Des Moines, the downtown Des Moines, as these miners went from bar to bar. Now, what's interesting about that is sometimes, like I said, they had too many cocktails and they would just pass out right in the main street, right there in downtown Des Moines. So the cops would find them all slumped over with the lights still shining, right? Sometimes their beam had gone off into the heavens. Other times they're shining in their buddy's face. But they would just pick them up with a bulldozer and put them all in that bucket of the bulldozer and drive the bulldozer to the jail and throw them in there in the drunk tank. And the next day they were fine. They had to pay a small fine. They'd get out. And the next night they'd do it all over again. So that was the time period between the establishment of the state and the growth of the economy because of coal and oil and alcohol. And eventually it became the biggest city in the late 1800s, the biggest city in Iowa. It was always was, became even more so, and of course is still today the largest city in the state. So guys, come on back. We're gonna have a lot more on Des Moines, and man, I don't know. It's gonna be the highlight of your life, probably.